feel like we've been so quiet about all the things that have been happening behind the scenes. And so we're just gonna go roll up to Boone and play some new stuff. And we didn't want to tell anybody about it because, I don't know, we just wanted to surprise people. And then we'll be at the Bradley Center on the Bon Iver show in February. Not long after that, the Field Report record comes out. It's getting closer. It's almost time.
The record was written in the summer. I'm swearing to him plowing through the trees. Toward the end of spring of 15, we did some dates with Jeff Tweedy in Europe, and we rapped like on a really, really good note. So then it was time to start thinking about making the next record. And around this time, there were a bunch of people in my life who were experiencing the ends of relationships. There were some friends who were bottoming out and crashing based on addiction and mental health stuff. The election campaign was in full swing, and watching America go through a parallel narrative to all these breakups individually, there's sort of a micro-macro thing happening. And so the resulting record, sort of like a windows down, elbow out the window, watching the world sort of get pulled apart. The harm in looking back. It's too easy to live there. You have to move on. And by you, I mean me. I grew up in Rochester, Minnesota. I went to Eau Claire starting in 2000. I was a freshman. And we started playing shows with this trio called the D'Armond Edison Trio. And that was Justin Vernon, Phil Cook, and Brad Cook. And in fact, that song, that Bon Iver song, Holocene, Third and Lake, it burned away the hallway. We lived at 310 Lake Street. That was our house. It burned down. There was community there. I was without a band for a little while, and then Justin asked me to join D'Armond Edison, primarily as a steel guitar player, and so they wanted to go to North Carolina. And I was just about to finish my degree, and I was just about to be engaged to my wife, and so I didn't want to go. And so they went, and then it was just me.
Am I the right key?
Left in Eau Claire for a year, and that's when I first started writing songs. I discovered that I could play guitar, but I hadn't discovered that I could write. You try something, and depending on the results you get and how long you try, you either decide that you can or you can't. And I decided that I couldn't. But then, in the absence of that community that I had been a part of, I discovered that I could. Depends on who we're lying to. We ate the fruit, learned the truth, and spit the pits in the corner of the room. I moved to Milwaukee with a few songs, zero prospects. That turned into more songs due to zero prospects. By the end of the first record, the wheels were starting to fall off. Booze was such a deep part of my process. At this point, I'm sober. It took me a long time to figure out how to write again. I felt completely naked. I mean, it's like you're concept of yourself and how you're presenting yourself to the world, like, is suddenly gone. All of the magic and the mystery is gone.
Check the wreckage, walk away, okay. I'm gonna change, I'm swearing till I'm blind.
My relationship with alcohol was starving my relationship with everything else.
You were in my blind spot. You were in my blind spot.
It was causing my relationship with my band to suffer. It was causing the relationship with my wife and family to suffer. I somehow was able to poke my head above the water and see that. And I'm grateful that I got that perspective at just the right time.
If I knew what I know, so far yet to go.
I found out that I had a lot more empathy as a narrator. I am very few of the narrators on this record.
What are we doing?
We're gonna track some strings.
You make a record?
I was a bit numb to myself. I was a bit anesthetized. Like, maybe my foot had fallen asleep. But I was imagining what it was like for someone who I know and care deeply about to be walking barefoot and cut their foot.
The great expanse of freedom bound our wrists by all accounts.
It's still a very verbose record, but for me, I think it's the most concise so far. We just had the time to make a record. There's a difference between writing songs and making records. And I think this one, we finally did them both.
While the tightrope trembled like a tumbler topped off for a...
We just treated it almost like a painting studio or like a pottery studio where you just show up and work and then contextualize the work later.
So to contextualize what's happening here, we are in the final week of mixing and making the Field Report record, LP3. This is Jane. We've been here working most days since May. And in the meantime, Jane was born at the end of July. We took August off for family. Back at it in September. We're almost done now.
Once more with feeling.
She likes all music.
She really does, and she prefers it loud.
And it's okay to have fun, I've learned.
Yeah, the record's almost done, man. I'm just putting the finishing touches on. We're really excited that you're going to put this record out. Okay, great, yeah. We'll send you the tapes. We'll send you the tapes tomorrow. Okay, buddy, we'll see you in New York City.
I think the last song, Everything I Need, brings everything together. It's a love song, and I think I'm in that one. If this happens, I still need you. If this happens, I still need you. If this happens, I still need you.
The way the song came together was searching for moments, because we tried a whole bunch of stuff, and until we were mixing, I would venture to say it wasn't working at all. And we just sat here and went, okay, let's figure it out. And it's one of those things in life and in record production and music where I don't even think we couldn't have done this by design.
Losing ground. And the echoes of the good times have all but stopped ringing out. We can run till we can't run no more, stranded halfway from anywhere to be.
There's one line that's an outlier. I don't trust this moment.
Maybe I don't trust this moment.
But I want to believe.
But I wanna believe.
Everything is maybe a disaster, but you, whoever the you is, whoever the narrator is, I guess in my head it's me and my wife, you are my mooring point. You are the thing keeping this on the ground, or in the air, or wherever it is. I think that's as overtly honest and sentimental as I've been on a record.
When everything is changing, you are everything I need.
It's like this whole thing, and suddenly you've got this whole machine, this whole camera, telescopic thing, or periscope, or whatever, all these lenses firing light back and forth through one another, and mirrors reflecting and refracting, and prismatic, you know, humanity all around. And that's the job of art.
Is any of that working?
Yeah.
Can we do it again?
Really?
Yeah, why the fuck not? I'm still able to talk. It means I haven't given it my all.
Prismatic humanity all around. I love that.